Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out. Let it. Wonderful name, Jesus. That's wonderful name, Jesus. That's wonderful name, Jesus. There is no other name I know. That's wonderful name, Jesus. That's wonderful name, Jesus. That's wonderful name, Jesus. There is no other name I know. Today is a day of joy. And that is why we need to bless the wonderful name of Jesus. In case you don't know, today is 2nd of March, the exact day when our Father in the Lord, Daddy Enoch Adejare Adeboye, was given to the world as a gift. Today, our Father in the Lord clocks 75 years. On the land of the living. Come and join me, sing hallelujah. Jehovah Jireh has done me well. Come and join me, sing hallelujah. Jehovah Jireh has done me well. He has done me well by making me a partaker of the grace of God upon this mighty man of God. He clocks 75 years today. So with joy in your heart, why don't you bow down your heads and let's thank God for him. Let's give glory to God for our Father and the Lord Daddy Adeboye. Let's say thank you, Jesus. Thanks, thanks. We give you thanks for all you have done in his life. We are so blessed. Our soul has found rest. Oh Lord, we give you thanks. Father Divine, we give you thanks. King of Kings, we give you thanks. Holy One of Israel, we give you thanks. Everlasting Redeemer, we give you thanks. Thank you for our Father in the Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you for making him to be alive today, 2nd of March. Thank you because in mercy, he clocked 75 years today on the land of the living. We are grateful. We are grateful. We are grateful. We are grateful. Almighty God, we are grateful. King of glory, we are grateful. Everlasting Redeemer, we are grateful. Covenant keeping God, we are grateful. God of all flesh, we are grateful for his life, for his wife, for his children, for his grandchildren, for the ministry committed to his end. Lord, we are grateful. For your grace upon his life, we are grateful. Thank you, Jesus. We give you praise. In Jesus' name, we have given thanks. Let's now pray for him. That birthday present that money cannot buy, that the Almighty God will give to him. We know all his children all over the world are crying to God on his behalf now. Let's join our voices with those that are praying. That Father, in the name of Jesus, we commit our Father and the Lord that they are able into your hand. Birthday present, money cannot buy, give to him. Shall we pray? Negegele baba baseke lendra lila yakataranda regeboromo sapla gele de getataranda libra kasakutu mojeye gebrobo kotata lide ligere ketakari gatataria. Lord God Almighty, we pray today as his children all over the world. We join our voices together, crying to you, Lord, that birthday present, that money cannot buy, give to daddy, give to daddy, give to daddy, give to our Father in the Lord in the name of
of Jesus. You know the heart desire of your son. You know those things he has been believing you for. You know that thing that will make his joy to be full. Release upon his life, oh God. Is it in the physical? Is it in the spiritual? Is it in the financial? Is it in the matrimonial? Is it in the ministerial? In every facet of his life. Lord, this very day of his birthday, smile on him in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Eternal Rock of Ages, we are so, so grateful. Almighty God, there is joy in our hearts today for your son, our father, Daddy Adeboye. Thank you for your hand upon his life for 75 solid years. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your compassion. Thank you for sustaining him. Thank you for keeping him in his love. Thank you for keeping his marriage. Thank you for keeping his children. Thank you for keeping his ministry. Despite all the enemy did for the past 75 years, you remained faithful to your son. You stood solidly behind him. You are the pillar of his support. No wonder no enemy was able to break him. We are grateful. Lord, we are grateful. Lord, we are grateful. That we are recipients of your grace upon his life, we are grateful. Accept our thanks in Jesus' name. As your children, we join our voices together today to ask you, O Lord, that we strengthen him anew and afresh. You will breathe on him. You will breathe on him. You will breathe on him. You will anoint his spiritual ears to hear you forever till he will come to you, my Father. Mahaliga kariaba sontoriaba. Draw him closer to you. Help him the more, Lord. The heights that you can possibly take any human being to, let him reach it in the name of Jesus. Back him up more than ever before. Send determined efforts more to him. All the projects and programs you are giving to him, make them successful in the name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Redeemer. The remaining days of his life, he will not spend in shame. He will not spend in sorrow. He will not spend in sickness in the name of Jesus. Over his life, over his wife, over his children, over his grandchildren, over everyone that is dear to him, he will not sorrow in the name of Jesus. Thank you for this precious gift given to our generation. We are grateful, Lord. And so, Lord, as we are going to your word this day, speak to us, encourage us, empower us, build us through the word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Though he cannot hear you, but God knows you are there. Shout, happy birthday, Daddy! Hallelujah. So today's topic, today, Thursday, March 2nd, the topic says the Comforter. The Comforter. Memory verse is taken from John 14 and verse 26. John 14, 26. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. The Comforter. One of the work of the Comforter, as we have been told here, is that he shall teach us all things. Every one of us, we need the Comforter's ministry. As a student, you need him to teach you. He knows the exact places where your lecturers have drawn out their questions. If the Holy Spirit will teach you, he will just guide you to the exact places where the questions have been drawn. And you will read the correct thing. And he will explain to you. And by the time you go to the exam, you say, I got it. If the Holy Spirit will do his work in your life. As businessmen and women, you need the ministry of the Comforter. He will give you all the ideas you need. And before you know it, you have edge over all your colleagues in the same industry. Why? Because he will teach you what to do. He will let you know what to do at the rightful time and how to do it in the rightful way. As a pastor, you need the minister of the Comforter. Because if he will not teach you, you will not be able to preach the rightful sermon that will affect your people positively. And when people are not blessed in your congregation, they'll be diminishing. They'll be coming and they'll be going. But when the Comforter is teaching you, You are able to teach your people and they are glued to your assembly because they are receiving the ministry of the Comforter. As a politician, you need the Comforter. You need him to teach you so that you can be a blessing to the people you are called to serve. So you can see that none of us on the face of the earth can do without the ministry of the Comforter. We need him to teach us. And the second thing we are told there is that he will bring all things to our remembrance, particularly students. You need this ministry. So that all you have been taught in class, all you have shared during group discussion, when you get to exam hall, you're able to remember. You need this ministry as a child of God, so that all the word of God you are hearing at the time when you are to make use of them, it can bring it to your remembrance. And that is why I want to quickly say, as a child of God, you need to study the word. It will remind you what you have learned, what you have read. So those of us who will not attend Sunday school to be taught the word of God, those of us who will be accepted, who will be absent from Bible study, every opportunity where we can be taught, we are not there. At every crossroad, when we need the word, the Holy Spirit will find nothing to remind us. God will help us in Jesus' name. I think somebody out there will say amen. Our text quickly is taken from 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 3 to 10. 2 Corinthians 1, 3 to 10. Blessed be God, the one, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all comfort, who comforteth us in all our tribulation, that we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble, by the comfort wherewith we ourselves are comforted of God. For as the sufferings of Christ abound in us, so our consolation also abounded by Christ. And whether we be afflicted, it is for your consolation and salvation, which is effectual in the enduring of the same suffering which we also suffer. Or whether we be comforted, it is for your consolation and salvation. Verse 7. And our hope of you is steadfast, knowing that as ye are partakers of the sufferings, so shall ye be also of the consolation. For we will not, brethren, have you ignorant of our trouble, which came to us in Asia, that we were pressed out of measure, above strength, in so much that we despaired even of life. But we had the sentence of death in ourselves, that we should not trust in ourselves, but in God, which raised the dead. 10, the last verse. Who deliver us from so great a death, and doth deliver, in whom we trust that he will yet deliver us. Quickly from where we have read, we can see that in verse 3 and 4, problems are a matter of time. Whether you like it or not, there will be time when the road will be rough on this journey to heaven. Isaiah 43 in verse 2. When thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee, and through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. It's a matter of time. He said when, not if. Not if thou pass. He said when. That tells you it's a matter of time. There will be a challenging period on this way. And that's why you need the help of the Holy Spirit. You need the ministry of the Comforter. And because our God is constantly constant, he has helped the people of old. He will help you. Hebrews 13:8. Hebrews chapter 13 and verse 8. Jesus Christ the same yesterday and today and forever. Whatever he has done in the time past, he can do it again because he's a repeater of miracle. He has helped the people of old. Definitely, he will help you and I if we will remain faithful to him. The Comforter. In addition to knowing God as the Father and as the Son, you also need to know him as God, the Holy Spirit. There are many marvelous things to know about the Holy Spirit. For example, he is the source of our power. Acts 1:8. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 1 and verse 8. But ye shall receive power After that, the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the utmost part of the earth. It's the spirit of power. When you are baptized with the Holy Spirit, you are given power. The question is, have you been baptized in the Holy Spirit? Also, the Holy Spirit is a wonderful teacher. John 14:26. John chapter 14 in verse 26. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. He's the best teacher. He's the great teacher. He's a wonderful teacher. And a revealer of secrets and of the future. John 16:13. Do you want to know what the future holds? Then partner with the Holy Spirit. He knows the future and he can reveal it to you. I don't know, maybe you are there that day when I was making reference to the departure of my mother to glory. I said the day previous, the Holy Spirit spoke to me. I was in my bath having my shower. And the Holy Spirit came to me and asked me, if I take away your mother now, what will you do? I heard him clearly. And I said, Lord, if you take him away, take her away, I will praise you. I will worship you. And that was the deal. The following day, my mother was on her way out of this world. She died right in my hand. And when she breathed her last, before she breathed her last, she was praying in tongues. When she breathed her last, instead of crying, weeping and crying, because the revealer had told me a day before, he knows secrets, he knows the future. I started worshiping God. I started magnifying God. The Holy Spirit is the revealer and he knows the future. He can reveal these secrets to us. John 16:13. How be it when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come. So nothing will really catch you unawares, he will prepare you. Although all these characteristics are wonderful, one characteristic I find so fascinating is that he is the Comforter. John 14:26. And like I said earlier on, we all need the ministry of the Comforter. If you have experienced him as the Comforter, you will be able to comfort others in their time of distress. 2 Corinthians 1:4, where we read, you can see the apostles saying all that they have passed through and they are still passing through. When you have passed through some difficult situation, it becomes easy for you to comfort others when they are in the same situation. You're able to tell them, I've been there. God is faithful. He saw me through. He will see you through. And by the time you narrate your experience, they are encouraged. They are strengthened. Verse 4 says, who comforted us in all our tribulations, that we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble, by the comfort wherewith we ourselves are comforted of God. So, when you add turbulent situations and God help you to weather the storm, when others are passing similar situations, you are able to tell them God is ever faithful. If you have not experienced sorrow, you cannot be of much use in comforting the sorrowful. When we encounter tragedies and sorrowful situations, the best people can do is to say comforting words like, take heart, sorry. Though, etc. In such situations, the ministry of the Comforter is needed to heal the hurt felt deep inside of you. Are you personally going through a sad circumstance? Are you so sorrowful that all human attempts to comforting you have failed? The Holy Spirit will reach out and comfort you today in Jesus' name. In times of sorrow, people do not express, some of us who occupy certain positions to express sorrow.
This should not be so. I once visited a family who suffered a great loss, and I began to shed tears after seeing what they were going through. Some people began to say, "Oh, you are the general overseer. You are not supposed to cry. We have come here to comfort those who are mourning. We should not be mourning." I simply told them, "This is Daddy talking. Leave me alone." In a similar situation, Jesus wept. If Jesus can weep, I am free to cry also. I know you remember that in John chapter 11, verse 35, it was recorded for us that Jesus wept. Jesus was so compassionate. He feels with us when we are in trouble. And that's why I pity those who don't know Jesus. Because at a time when they should enjoy the ministry of the Holy Spirit, it will not be there for them because they don't know him. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 14 to 16. Hebrews 4, 14 to 16. "Seeing then that we have a great high priest that is passed into the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold fast our profession. For we have not an high priest which cannot be touched with the feeling of our infirmities, but was in all points tempted like as we are, yet without sin. Let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need." He identified with us. That's why he came in the flesh. He knew what it means to suffer pain. So, if Jesus can feel for people that are in pain, people that are sorrowful, why should we pretend as if nothing is at stake? And that's what Daddy said. He was trying to correct him. People said, "You, a good general overseer, why should you be crying?" He said, "Well, I'm human. My father also felt pain for people who were pained through his earthly ministry. I'm just taking after my father." You as leaders, how do you relate to your people when they are passing through turbulent situations? Let's continue. So Daddy said, "I am free to cry also because Jesus wept while he was here." He said, "One of my sons lost his mother, and it was extremely difficult to comfort him. His mother had suffered to train her three children, and these children had planned to take good care of her. She, however, passed on while they were still trying to find their feet. This brother began to ask God why he called his mother home at a time when they had not been able to do anything for her. The Lord simply replied, saying, 'Your mother has come to be with me. Can you take better care of her on earth than I'm doing here in heaven?' On hearing these words, he dried his tears, apologized to the Lord, and moved on." Just like me. Anytime I want to feel, I wish my mother is alive. Now that life is a little bit better and I will have taken care of her, I will have done this, I have done that, then I will remember the Lord took her to be with himself. He's sweeter over there. Then I'm encouraged and I can face life again. Are you in a situation where you need the comfort of the Holy Spirit? He will reach out and touch you today. He will dry your tears, calm your fears, and give you a greater hope. Prayer point. Let's pray for believers going through sorrow everywhere. Let's ask that they will receive the soothing comfort of the Comforter. Shall we begin to pray? We commit all your children all over the world that may be passing through sorrowful experiences now. Lord, come to their aid. Lord, come to their aid. The Holy Spirit, comfort them, comfort them, comfort them, comfort them. Speak to them in the language they will understand. Heal their pains, oh God. Maybe those that have lost their job, maybe those that have loved their loved ones, maybe husband, wife, or children. Father divine, comfort them, every true child of God, every believer that is going through some sorrowful experiences now, Almighty God, comfort them, comfort them, comfort them, comfort them, comfort them. In Jesus' name we pray. Again, I want us to pray for our Father in the Lord, that they are able here. I want you to say, Father, please, for the rest of his life, don't let him know sorrow. Shall we pray? Our Lord and our God, we want to thank you once again for our Father and the Lord, that they are able here. Father, we pray today that for the rest of his life, he will not know sorrow. He will not know shame. He will not know sorrow. He will not know shame. He will not know sorrow. He will not know shame. In the name of Jesus, over his life, over his wife, over his children, over his ministry, over everything that has to do with him, he will know no shame. He will know no sorrow. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Redeemer. Prayer answering God, we thank you. Every prayer point we have raised today for believers that are passing through sorrowful experiences, and particularly for our Father in the Lord, Jehovah, hear and answer in Jesus' name. Dear Holy Spirit, we want to enjoy your ministry for the rest of our lives. We want you to do all things. We want you to be revealing secrets unto us. We want you to be reminding us when need be. Jehovah, help us in the name of Jesus. Cause us to enjoy your ministry forever in Jesus' name. Thank you, everlasting Redeemer. Glory be to your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you. Can we please sing in 15 from our devotional book?
Oh, spread the tidings round wherever man is found.
Thank you. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven.
Sing out.
Let it rain.